On Sunday, the government released a clean car policy that takes a carrot and stick approach to meeting the Climate Change Commission's aim of ensuring nearly all imported vehicles are electric by 2035. If you import a zero or low emission vehicle into New Zealand from the 1st of July, whoops, a couple of weeks, was it? You'll receive a rebate of between $8,625 off the sticker price, the greater amount being for fully electric vehicles. But from the 1st of January next year, and that's what Jenny May's just been discussing with Ross Townsend, if you import what's classified as a higher emitting vehicle, you'll pay a penalty. That's only on new stuff. It's not on existing stock, or what the government prefers to call a fee for the privilege. It was an announcement welcomed by many who want to see action on climate change in Aotearoa, but there have also been questions asked, like those we heard just before the break, about how fair and practical the policy really is, particularly for people for whom work vehicles don't come as EVs very often. So we're very grateful to welcome to the studio Transport Minister Michael Wood. Morena, Minister, thank you for coming.
Good morning, John.
You know what bewildered me yesterday? Yesterday at Field Days, the Prime Minister was asked about a carve-out for people who use utility vehicles for farming and for construction work or whatever. And she said, and I quote, "We gave it a really strong consideration because we recognised that there wasn't an alternative in the market right now." Well, if there's not an alternative in the market right now, why have this policy?
We have this policy because we've got to transition our fleet. New Zealand has one of the dirtiest fleets in the world at the moment. Our emissions have increased 90% since 1990, and transport contributes 47% of our CO2 emissions. The Climate Commission has just told us what we've got to do if we want to get down to net zero, which in theory nearly everyone signed up to and says, yes, we want to get there. Well, we've got to start making some changes if we want to turn that around. And this policy reduces 9.2 million tonnes of CO2 emissions. It's one of the most effective things we can do.
Where does that estimate come from? Whose estimate is that?
That's the Ministry of Transport's modelling work.
Okay.
That's right. Right. And obviously the Climate Commission has also leaned in and said this is an important measure that we've got to undertake.
Okay. So, look, I think a lot of people are going to be nodding in agreement that we have to reduce our carbon emissions. I mean, I don't think anyone's arguing against that. So that's the carrot stuff, right? That's incentivising around...
Can I just make a point on that, John? It's actually no good for people just to say, yes, we agree, we need to reduce our emissions, unless we're actually prepared to move forward with some policies.
Okay.
This is my criticism. I saw Judith on here yesterday. We can declare climate emergencies, we can vote to have a climate commission, but if we just say no because it's a bit tricky every time we look to change something, then we're just saying words and not doing anything.
I couldn't agree more. And I mean, that's just common sense, right? So that's the carrot stuff, the incentivising around buying EVs. But the fees and the penalties around non-EVs when there aren't, and the Prime Minister herself said this yesterday, and I quote again, "We recognise there isn't an alternative in the market right now." So what are farmers meant to do?
Sure. Well, there's a couple of important things to clarify here. And I listened to the interview with Ross, who was a good, plain-spoken Kiwi farmer, and really good to have his views on the table. But I did notice in his interview, he talked about, he used the word ban. No one here is banning a farmer from having a ute. On the 1st of January, farmers who currently have their utes will be able to continue using them. There'll be no fee that applies to them. There will still be utes on the market. There will be no fees or discounts which apply to second-hand vehicles which are being traded within the market. And we've got really clear information on the table from a number of car manufacturers that in the coming 12 to 24 months, we are going to get a supply of hybrid or other cleaner vehicles coming into the market.
Are we in the next 12 to 24 months, these vehicles that can be used on the farms? So who are the manufacturers that are bringing those in?
Yeah, well, I'm not going to mention specific manufacturers, otherwise you have a minister who looks like they're favouring particular manufacturers.
A number of them on
the record.
I really appreciate you coming in, but I think there's a convenience in you not, because I've gone looking for them. Toyota say they're not coming within 2 years. Ford are making Lightning, but it is for the American market and they are not mass producing one for right-hand drive environments. So they're not coming, are they?
No, we have a number of them on record, including one of the ones that you've mentioned, saying that we're likely to have hybrid vehicles coming in the next 12 to 24 months. And that's going to make a real difference. Look, the question of exemptions, as the PM said, was looked at. The problem when you have a program like this, if you start looking to exempt one sector, then other sectors start to make the arguments and before long you've diluted the scheme, you don't actually get the benefit from it that you need. But as I'll make that point really clearly, that no one's taking utes away from people on the 1st of January, there will still be opportunities to get them. And another really important point is this. Until this year, no clean car standard, no clean car discount. That's why New Zealand's got one of the dirtiest fleets in the world. We're now giving our importers in New Zealand the tools to go back to the manufacturers and say, we need the supply of the clean vehicles because our customers are demanding them and the government's putting a mandate on. This is going to help more Kiwis, including in future years, farmers get access to the clean vehicles they want.
One of the reasons our fleet is so dirty is that relative to other countries in the OECD, it's old. It's about 14 and a half years old on average cars. Average cars, they're old cars, right? Isn't the problem with this that people will hold on longer to their old and often dirty car?
No, the main reason that our fleet is the dirtiest in the OECD is because we're one of only three countries, including Russia and Australia, who haven't had a standard until now. And we've now brought that in. And that's going to make a huge difference because importers now have to, well, they're incentivised now to bring in cleaner vehicles as other countries are. This policy is going to make sure that we do get a cleaner fleet coming into the country. 50% of the vehicles that come in will either be unaffected or will have a discount. And that's going to give heaps of Kiwis more choices to get into a cleaner vehicle.
Yes. The argument that the Nats are making, and they use the Tesla, and David Seymour's been using the Tesla. Why should people who earn the kind of money that you and I earn have subsidies at the expense of people who are never in their life going to be able to afford a Tesla?
Well, a couple of important points there. The first is that we have put a price cap on.
And $80,000?
That's a change we've made since the policy was last talked about a couple of years ago. So the very most expensive vehicles are cut out of the system. But many, many other vehicles, down to your Nissan Leafs, some of which are retailing down at around the $10,000 to $12,000 mark, will now be eligible for discounts.
But if they're retailing around the $10,000 to $12,000 mark, they're already in New Zealand, they're existing stock, aren't they? They're second-hand cars circulating.
Some of those
won't be eligible for the scheme?
Well, no, used imports are eligible for the scheme.
But are used imports coming to the country at that kind of price level?
Well, used imports are coming in at a range of price levels. And so what the scheme will do is across a whole range of makes and models, we'll get cheaper, cleaner vehicles into the system. And another one of the key changes that we have made since the policy was talked about a couple of years ago, we have now opened it up to hybrids, and also actually some of the cleaner petrol vehicles from the 1st of January next year will be eligible for discounts.
Give me an example.
Oh, not off the top of my head, yeah. But we can send through that information, and that's available up on the website.
You see,
there's a whole range of vehicles.
It seems to me, and I became obsessed with Norway last night. I mean, what is it? Way over half. I think it may even be two-thirds of their fleet.
Countries with these schemes are getting 20 to 50% of their vehicles coming in being clean EV vehicles now.
But more cars in Norway are EV than not. But I'm looking at what they're doing there. And first of all, the EV infrastructure. I mean, you can't even drive for a few hundred metres in Norway without passing a charging machine. I mean, so have we whacked a theoretical best will in the world template on a country that for all sorts of reasons just isn't ready for this yet? And we're an agricultural country. People use utes and there ain't no EV utes on the market.
We're a country that does have a really important agricultural sector. We're actually one of the most urbanised societies on the planet, John, as well. And this will get clean cars into the garages and the driveways of many, many New Zealanders.
Will it?
Look, the answer to your question, John, is we either say this is a bit tricky and there's work to do, or we do nothing. And that's the alternative that I'm hearing from the opposition. This is too hard and there are political arguments we can make, so we're not going to do anything. Well, we're not going to go down that path. We're doing the work alongside this to make sure that we've got a charging network up and going. We've funded over 1,100 chargers around New Zealand. On the state highway network now, we've got a charger every 75 kilometres along nearly all of that network. And we're setting up an EV leadership council to make sure that we do the work around that infrastructure so that this system works really well. The key thing about this, John, this is happening. In 10 years' time, there aren't going to be petrol vehicles being produced by many of the world's leading car manufacturers. Most countries in 2030 are not even allowing internal combustion engines into their countries. This is about a transition, and in that period, this is about us helping Kiwis to bring down the costs and to smooth out the transition for them.
Look, I've had a big rap, and that's the carrot stuff. I just think the concern is around the stick, right? You say, let's do it, because if we don't, the alternative means we're doing nothing. But the ruminant in the room here is actually that if we're talking about greenhouse gases, it's methane that is equally problematic. 85% of methane comes from agricultural production. The government's doing nothing in that space. So are you forced to tackle carbon because you're not doing enough on methane?
The government's doing a lot to work with the agricultural sector in terms of reducing emissions from that sector. It's on a slightly different path to the other emissions profiles, but we're doing a lot of work with the sector in that area, and that's a really important part of it. My job's to look after the transport part, and we are 47% of CO2 emissions in this sector. And the thing about the agricultural sector is a really important point. who's going to be on the front line of climate change? Who's going to be vulnerable to drought? Who's going to be vulnerable to extreme weather events? It's going to be our cockies who are at the forefront of that. If we don't take action on climate change, they suffer and we suffer as a country as well. That's why this action's so important.
So you are standing, final question, you are standing by this policy?
100%. We have to take action to lower our emissions. This will help more Kiwis get into clean vehicles.
Michael Wood, Transport Minister, thanks for joining us this morning. We really appreciate your time.